During the Buddha's time, there was a certain monk who had become filled with lust for a woman. This greatly affected his ability to focus on his practice. When brought before the Buddha asked him, "Monk, is it true? Is it true that you are overcome by passion for a woman?"
"Yes, my lord."
"Monk, women are lustful, wasteful, wicked, and degraded. Why do you allow your passions to grow for a vile woman?" Then the Buddha proceeded to tell a story of the past. A long time ago, in Benares, there was a Brahmin family. On the day of the birth of their son, the parents lit a fire and kept it burning at all times until the boy was 16. The parents wanted their son to renounce the worldly life and live as an ascetic in the forest while worshiping the Lord of Fire. However, at that age, the son was more concerned with chasing girls. So, on his 16th birthday, the parents presented the son with a choice. "Son, if you prefer the life of a householder, then you must go to Takasila with a teacher's fee of 1,000 pieces and study until your education is done. However, if you instead see the harms and dangers inherent to a life based on desires, then take your fire and worship the Lord of Fire in the forest for the rest of your days."
"Mother, father, I will live the life of a householder and take a wife. I shall go to the great learned city of Takasila and find a teacher and return to you after my studies are done."
And so, the son set out to Takasila and found a wise Brahmin and requested instruction. The son dedicated himself to studying under this great teacher and learned all the texts that the Brahmin had to teach. After 5 years, the son returned home.
"My son, have you completed your studies?"
"I have, mother. I've completed all the texts."
"Then have you decided how you will live your life?"
"Yes, mother. I will now go take a wife and live the life of a householder."
"Ah, I see. But have you learned the text of distress and sorrow?"
"Mother, I have not."
"Then you have not learned all that there was to study. Return to your teacher and request that he teaches you the text of distress and sorrow."
At that time, it just so happened that the Brahmin teacher had an old mother that he took care of. His mother was 100 years old, and the Brahmin teacher bathed, fed, and tended to her personally with his own hands. Because of this, he was shunned by his neighbors. The Brahmin decided to move out into the forest and live alone with his mother. There, the Brahmin teacher built a hut, provided food, and took care of his mother. The young student had to venture out into the forest to find his Brahmin teacher. There, he requested further instruction on the text of distress and sorrow. The Brahmin teacher thought to himself,
"What is this text of distress and sorrow that he speaks of? I already taught him everything. He said that his mother told him that he had to learn this new text, but there is no such text. Ah, she must want me to teach him how wicked women are. My student, from today onwards, in order to learn the text of distress and sorrow, you will have to take my place in caring for my mother. You will wash her with your own hands, as you rub her hands, feet, head, and back. Be skillful in exclaiming her beauty in the past. As you wash and perfume her hands and feet, praise their beauty and regardless of what she says or does, come report all to me, without shame or fear. If you do this, you will master the text of distress and sorrow. If you fail, you shall remain ignorant of them forever."
"Yes, Master, I will do as you instruct."
And so, the youth did as his master instructed. As he washed and massaged the old lady's feet, he said,
"Madam, your feet are so elegant, even at your current age. I imagine how beautiful they would have been at the height of your youth. I venture that none could compare to your gracefulness."
The old woman was confused at the young man's intentions, but enjoyed the attention and praise. It had been a long time since anyone treated her as an object of beauty or desire. As a youth washed and massaged the old woman's back, he said,
"Madam, your skin color and bone structure is excellent. I wonder how wonderful your skin and body looked back at the height of your youth and beauty. If only I was lucky enough to have seen you in those days, I bet you would have taken my breath away."
And when the youth washed and massaged the old woman's hands, he said,
"Madam, even the touch of your hands now brings tingles throughout my body. I could only imagine how beautiful these hands would have been at the height of your beauty. Anyone would have been lucky to be touched lovingly by these hands."
At this, the old lady could no longer restrain herself. She had allowed herself to believe that this young man truly had an attraction to her, and this kindled many old emotions and desires that she had put away due to old age. As her long-lost passions returned to her, she convinced herself that she was in love with this young man, and that he was in love with her. The old lady said,
"Young man, do you desire me?"
"Mistress, I surely do."
"Then young man, we should be together as man and woman."
"Mistress, that I cannot do. Your son is my teacher, and he would not permit that."
"Young man, if my son gets in the way of our love, then you should just kill him."
"Mistress, I could not do such a thing. I've learned so much from him. How could I, for the sake of passion, kill my teacher?"
"Young man, if you cannot do it for the sake of our passion, then I will do it myself."
As instructed, the youth reported everything that happened to his master. The master then contemplated and discerned how much more life his mother had remaining. In his contemplation, he discerned that she was destined to die on this very day. So, the master said to the youth,
"My pupil, we will put her to the test."
The teacher had the youth go out and cut a medium-sized tree. Then they shaped the wood into a figure in the shape and size of the teacher. They laid it down on the teacher's bed and tied a string to it. The teacher then said,
"Student, take this string and axe and go to my mother. Use the string to guide her to my bed."
And so, the youth did as his teacher instructed, and brought the string and an axe to the old woman. She followed the string to the bed. The old woman raised the axe and prepared to strike her son, the perceived obstacle to her passion. However, when she struck the wooden body, she was shocked to find that it was not a real human body. The teacher, standing nearby, said,
Mother, what are you doing?
The mother was shocked. The shock cleared the passion from her mind, and she realized what she had done. She couldn't bear the guilt of her intentions and actions. The stress caused her to die at that very moment. The teacher, holding no ill will towards the being that gave him life and raised him, saw to his mother's cremation. He paid his respects as a loving son and did not focus on the last moments of his mother's life. The teacher then said, "There's no such text as the text of distress and sorrow. One cause of distress and sorrow are women. Your mother wished for you to learn how wicked women truly are. You have now witnessed it with your own eyes, and know how lustful and passion-lost women are." And after this, he sent his student home. After returning home for a second time, his mother asked, "Son, have you learned the text of distress and sorrow?"
"Mother, I have."
"What have you decided?"
"I will forsake the householder life and enter the forest and live my life as a hermit worshipping fire."
And so, the young man took the fire that had been maintained since his birth and headed into the forest, much to the happiness of his parents. The Buddha then said, "So you see, monk, how lustful, vile, and dangerous women are." After that, the monk's mind was ready and focused, and the Buddha preached the Four Noble Truths, after which the monk became enlightened as a Sotapanna. And then, the Buddha identified the Jataka story by saying, "In those days, Parakapilani was the mother, Mahakasapa was the father, Ananda was the student, and I was the teacher."
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.